And it's even up till the 80s, computer science was sort of 30 to 40% women, and we've just tanked. You know, we talked about Steve Jobs. There's these incredible photographs from the launch of the Macintosh in the 80s. Yeah. And there's the Rolling Stone pictures that were published. And so the historic record shows this group, actually, of 10 people in a pyramid, actually 11, 7 men and 4 women. And every photograph you see with the Mac team, Joanna Hoffman, who was the product manager, a great teammate of Steve Jobs, Susan Carey did all the graphics and user interface, artist side. None of them made it into the Jobs movie in the Mac scene. They're not even cast. And every man in the photographs is in the movie with a speaking role. And so it's debilitating to our young women to have their history almost erased or uncalled.
Okay, and other than the blanket discrimination, how does that happen? I mean, what's the interest of somebody not recognizing the contribution of women? How do they benefit from that?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't see any real benefit of
it. Of course they're not. So why do they do it?
I don't know. But it's something we need to get over. You know, Katherine Johnson, African-American woman who calculated the trajectories for Alan Shepard, John Glenn, who wouldn't fly without Katherine checking the math, and the Apollo mission. You know, there's no African-American woman technical person in the Apollo movies that I ever saw as a kid. Yeah. You know, we got to get these in there because if you know your past, as we're discussing, your future is different.